Here's a chart I worked up to work chevrons on your knitter bed only. Now I chose to have two center stitches in the middle of the point going up, and then here, because I'm moving six stitches to the right and six stitches to the left, I'll have two stitches going down as well. But I need to do a make one there, so it may not look like these stitches here. Also, I do have two purl stitches on the outside edge. This way here, one stitch on each side is the selvage when you're sewing it up. The other stitch is going to be the plain knit stitch going straight up and down. And basically, it's just a matter of two rows. You have your transfer rows, transfer your stitches over, and make your stitches in the certain points there. Push the carriage two rows, and then do the same thing again for as long as you need. Here is what I have so far. I have decreases in the center here, the increase in between where the end of the arrows were, decrease again, that's where the arrow point was, an increase, one increase on the left here, and then I have four stitches on the left instead of two on the chart. But anyways, now that I got this going, I could kind of see what needles I have to do, but I'm going to put the camera pointing down on the bed so you can see what needles I'm choosing to do this. And as you see, it looks more of a scallop right now, but that's because it's still on the bed. Once I take it off and I take the waist yarn off, then this will come into those points of the chevron. Starting at center zero, I leave left one and right one alone. I will bring actually 12, but here's six stitches to the left, which is left two to left seven, and then the same on the right side. Now these stitches are going to be transferred one over, so that right one and left one's going to have two stitches on it. But now for the next one, there's six, space two, two, four, six. There's my four on the end. So I got on the right here, two, four, six, leave two, two, four, six. There's my four on the end. Of course, like I said, you want to have two stitches on the end. Well, you could have more than that, really doesn't matter. So now all I need to do is transfer these stitches. So I remember I'm doing six stitches. I'm going to start in the center here. You could start over here if you want. But just so I could remember what I'm doing, I'm going to take the first three stitches on the left, and then I'm going to take the next three stitches to the left, and I'm moving those over to the right. Then I'm going to take to the right of zero there and move these to the left. Now I'm off to the side here, so it is a little bit harder for me to see these. Now I have my other two sets of six stitches. There's the two set stitches in the middle that will stay the same. So again, I transfer the six stitches to the right, six stitches to the left. And over here, I do the same. Now, if you want to have eyelets in between them, you would only have one needle in the middle there. But because I have two, I need to increase a stitch, and I like to push my needles back. Now, I need to go, if I look at the material, I have the V on the here. Here's the decrease, so it's pointing down. I need to go on that last stitch that was transferred over and just put on that empty needle. And if you're not sure about that, you see these two empty needles. Well, I can't go to the right or left, I have to go to the right on the right side. And on the left, again, just pulling that purl bump up from the row before. Same over here. But on the end, you only have that one stitch you're increasing. So you just got to remember to go to those set of six stitches and leave the end needles alone. Now I'm going to knit two rows. And I'm going to do that again. So here's the center two, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 1, 2, 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 6. Now those that one in the middle, 8, 10, 12, this is for the left. Two needles leave alone, 2, 4, 6. I have my four needles on the end, so I know I'm right. So I'm just going to continue doing this for a while, and then I'll show you what it looks like in the end. Well, here's the piece off of the machine, and as you can see, the bottom does have that curve to it, but the top does not. Maybe I should have, because it's not laying flat there, I probably should have cast it on or knitted the first row one or two numbers up just to have that looser, just like I do the bind off. Now, as you look here, it does look like just one stitch going up, but as I had the center one, two going down, I think the next time I'm going to try one stitch in the middle and try to make this look a little bit more uniform with one stitch, one stitch, one stitch. So this is how I did the second one. Instead of having two stitches in the center here, I only have one. So as I move six stitches over, there's going to be three stitches on this one needle. This column here should have M's on it because I'm going to make one there. And of course, the make ones over here, the two of them and two of that. So same as before, but instead of two stitches in the middle, one stitch. So I designated right one as my center stitch. So I go 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 6, but then I have to work the next one. So 2, 4, 6, leave one back, 2, 4, 6. This time I have two needles on the outside here. 2, 4, 6, leave 1, 2, 4, 6. And then I start moving my stitches over. So of course you have to go either here, here, or here. It doesn't matter if you start on the right or the left. But just like I showed before, you're going to take and move six stitches over. And again, you could have more than six stitches. You don't have to have exactly as I have. I'm just showing you the technique. And then I have to move the left six stitches over. And this is where you want to concentrate, because at times I will take and transfer those over and then I'm like, what did I do? So again, I'm putting six stitches on the right, moving over to the left, six stitches on the left, moving it to the right, and then the last set here. So you want to start in the middle, because if I take these, I can't move it over. You have to start in the center of the chevron point. Now, one thing I did do different on this one was when I cast it on, I went up to tension dowel 7 for the first row, hoping that it was going to be the looser cast on. Now, of course, I have to do the make one. Looks like that stitch didn't quite get on the needle all the way, but I could just bring it forward. All I really need to do is get that purl bump from the row before. Now, I do have to get it back on the hook. And then here you have the two outside ones. And again, two more outside ones. The outside of the chevron is what I mean. And looks like that stitch I didn't quite get on the needle all the way, so I'm bringing that needle out. There. So now I'm going to knit two rows and just keep transferring those stitches over. And you'll be able to see where the points are going. That's the down point, the up point. So let me do a few more rows and show you what it looks like. So here we have the two samples I did. The first one with the two stitches going up and down at the point, and then one stitch going up and down at the point. Now I did wash and block these. This one here was still curling at the top. As you see, it still is because I have it loose here. This one here has a little bit of a curl to the top. And as you notice, the points on top here are not as prominent as the points on the bottom. I wasn't able to fix that down here, but now here you have that, it looks like one stitch actually going down, but then you got the one stitch going up. But you could see the stitches going on the vertical there.